a teenager dies, gets set on fire by the police, was not the target of anything. Let's put up the picture for a mass. 15-year-old Brett Rosenau. Brett's father was also killed by police back in 2006 when Brett's mother was still pregnant with him. I'm taking you to Albuquerque, New Mexico. This teenager was barricaded in a house with a murder suspect reportedly died of smoke inhalation when the home caught fire after police fired munitions into the building during an hour-long standoff. So what led to this? The Albuquerque Police Department, according to them, they said they were pursuing a 27-year-old Qiaunt Kelley of an armed carjacking, vehicle theft, and probation violation. Kelley barricaded himself in the house, and police said they opted to use powder and smoke irritants when all other tactics failed. A fire then erupted, which they know is a potential, by the way. Kelley fled the home, but young Brett was discovered inside dead. Let me show you an image of the fire, okay? All right, it's not a small thing. That's what the police did. The cops did that, okay? Albuquerque Police Chief Harold Medina has acknowledged the devices used to introduce irritants into the home may have caused the fire. Let's put up a picture of the chief here. We have not identified the officers who are involved. We are looking for that information as we speak. So let's talk about the department's history of excessive force. The Albuquerque Police Department is currently under a federal monitor as part of an agreement with the Department of Justice after a history of excessive force against its citizen. Brett's death is being investigated by a multi-agency task force, the cops said. They promised to release body cam, drone, and robot camera footage from the incident. The family is currently crowdfunding to pay for funeral expenses, and we're gonna help them. Let's put up the information for the crowdfunding. You have gogetfunding.com, and you can type in the name of Brett Rosenau. So sad. I have so many questions. My first question is, why would they introduce these devices not being sure of the occupants inside of the building? That is common protocol. We've heard this routinely from analysts connected to policing. You do not engage in that manner when you are unaware of what's inside. You wait it out. So Adrienne, I got a question about protocol here. There's a child inside who is now dead. The police department, they have acknowledged that the devices used likely is what led to the death. Why would the police do such a thing not knowing what's inside of the building?
I think it's just sheer negligence. The fact is that they have no accountability, so why should they care? I think we're seeing this time and time again with police departments across the nation. By virtue of having all of these legal shields available to them, it showed you that there is truly a lack of accountability, and thus why should they look to necessarily protect the human life of those who they did sign on to protect and to serve? It just becomes more and more of a reality of the fact that police are seeming to cause more damage and more injury than they are preventing it. And it just really does make you wonder what is going on and why are we investing so many of our resources into this type of department and agency when they're not even maybe even considering whether we will be harmed by their actions.
Yeah, and once again, they're playing hot the pickle. We do not know the identity of the officers involved. We have not heard an outcry from members of law enforcement, leaders of law enforcement about this teenager who is now dead, was not target of any investigation. But once again, we're having to hold them accountable by exposing it. All right.